You're watching a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
Hello and welcome to Aberdeen, the site of the 34th annual state volleyball tournament. It's Class B here in Aberdeen. I'm Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, AM 1230 and FM 98.1 KWSN. It is semifinal night tonight. Two great matches coming. Glad to have with us at courtside. She helped Northwestern get five titles, coached them to five state titles. Still the coach at Northwestern, Nora Groff. Nora, glad to have you courtside. I know you'd rather be out there
tonight's
today.
Game will go on to play.
Yeah, but this is a great seat to watch this match from.
Let's take a look at what's happening tonight. First of the double A's. Sioux Falls, O'Gorman, and Huron going to go at it tonight down in Yankton. O'Gorman and Huron, and then it's Watertown and Roosevelt. The only surprise there, Roosevelt, the 7 seed, getting into the semifinals. Roosevelt with a thrilling match against Aberdeen last night. Roosevelt beat Watertown first round of the districts to get on a little bit of a roll right now. Class A in Watertown, Sioux Falls Christian making their 8th straight trip to the tournament. They get Dakota Valley and then Miller and Mount Vernon Plankinton. And here in Aberdeen, later we'll talk about Silly Buttes and Chester area. But coach, let's talk about Warner and Parker. You've seen a lot of Warner over the years. It's either been Warner or Northwestern as champions in Class B 12 times in the last 15 years. Is this Warner team, their two-time defending champ, are they just as good as they've been the last couple of years?
You know, this Warner team has a little bit different dynamic to it, but they're still every bit as solid as they've been in the last several years. They're led by their senior, Ashley Roselle, and she's arguably one of the best players in South Dakota, and going to play at Northern next year. And, you know, she's just a phenomenal player, and she makes everyone around her better. And so this team, though it's different than the two teams that they had previously, is every bit as good as they've been.
How about Parker? Parker comes in as the number 4 seed. They have some size, and if you want to win championships, you have to have some size.
Yes, and if you want to play well against Warner, you're going to need some size. Warner has good size to them. Parker has a 6'3 middle. Their other middle is very tall. They're really good athletes all the way around. Parker provides a balanced attack and a big block, and so I think it's going to be a blocking battle at the net tonight.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups again. The Parker Pheasants and the Warner Monarchs starting lineups for tonight. Start off with we'll start with Parker or Warner, which one is? All right, we'll do Parker, the Parker Pheasants. Here's their starting lineup. Allison Sanner, excellent outside hitter. She is fun to watch. You got Jenny Smith as their setter. Hannah Carlson, Hannah Herlin, Riley Christensen, Contessa Harold at 6'3". She's going to have a big night. And then Lexi Olson is the libero. On the other side, Warner. Warner, the two-time defending champ. Alexis Basil, Riley Furman, Mallory Testerman. Testerman had a pretty good night last night. Steinbach, Ashley Roselle, one of the better players in the state, along with Peyton Ellings, just a freshman at 6 foot. And then Caitlin Buzel as the libero. We are just about ready for you to be introduced to the players, the coaches, and the officials tonight. Glad to have you with us. SDPB.org. Reminder, the third place in the championship match tomorrow night on SDPB1. All right, let's get a chance to meet everybody and then play some volleyball. Let's hear from our public address announcer here in Aberdeen tonight, Ken Hansen at the mic.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The City of Aberdeen, Aberdeen Central High School, and the South Dakota High School Activities Association, its member schools and its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard welcome you to Golden Eagles Arena on the campus of Aberdeen Central High School for the semifinal session of the 2014 Class B State High School Volleyball Tournament. Today's semifinals will feature, in the first game, the Warner Monarchs and the Parker Pheasants. In our second game will be the Chargers of Sully Buttes and the Chester Area Flyers. Each year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association sponsors statewide events in athletics, journalism, music, and speech. One of the elements which is common to all these activities is the need for good sportsmanship. We hope that you enjoy these state volleyball tournament matches, that you back your team in a positive manner, and you let your good sportsmanship show throughout all of the semifinal matches tonight. At this time, would you please remain standing as we honor our flag with the singing of the national anthem. The national anthem will be sung this evening by the women of the high school choir from Hanson High School under the direction of Suzanne Amiel. We would remind all in attendance that the proper respect is to remove all headgear, face the flag, standing at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans in active duty military, not in uniform, have the option of saluting. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you, ladies. And now let's meet tonight's participants. First, for the designated visitors, the Parker Pheasants. A 5'9" inch senior, number 3, Allison Sanner. A 5'4" inch senior, number 4, Jenny Smith. A 5'7" inch junior, number 6, Hannah Carlson. A 5'11" inch junior, number 16, Hannah Herlin. A 5'11" inch sophomore, number 24, Riley Christensen. And 6'3" inch junior, number 30, Contessa Harold. The libero is 5'7" inch sophomore, number 1, Lexi Olsen. The Parker Pheasants are coached by Jennifer Becker and Roger Kinnick, and celebrating her 54th birthday today, head coach for the Parker Pheasants, Jill Christensen. And now for the designated home team, the starters for the Warner Monarchs. 5'4" inch sophomore number 1, Alexis Basil. 5'6" inch sophomore number 3, Riley Furman. 5'6" inch junior number 6, Mallory Testerman. A 5'8" inch junior number 7, Callie Steinbach. 5'11" inch senior number 8, Ashley Roselle. And a 6-foot freshman number 16, Peyton Ellingson. The libero is 5'4" inch senior number 4, Caitlin Basil. The Monarchs are coached by Bobby Duder, Taylor Roselle, and Deshub Hayline. Head coach for the Warner Monarchs is Carrie Jung. Officials for tonight's contest, line judges Mark Ulrich and Tammy Hossman. Down official is Brian Kringen. Up official is Carla Stedeker. Tonight's alternate is Beth Conroy. Let's play volleyball.
All right, Coach. You're the Parker Pheasants. What is the key for them going up against Warner tonight?
Well, first off, they need to handle the nerves of the match and come out ready to play right away. Warner's a team that likes to come out ready to go, and they need someone who's going to meet that match when they come up there.
Parker hasn't been here. They missed a year. They were here in 2012. Don't know how many of those ladies are playing tonight that were there in 2012, but it is a little bit different not being here.
Yes, and so a lot of those girls on the Parker team don't have the state tournament experience that Warner does. They've been here three straight years, and you know they're comfortable out on this court. You know, they play a lot here in Golden Eagles Arena, and so they're very comfortable with their hometown crowd right here supporting them. And so, you know, for Parker to come out, I'm sure their girls are a little bit nervous, and as athletes should be before a big event. So we'll see who handles the nerves right away, but they need to come out ready to go because Warner's always ready from the first whistle.
All right, what does Warner have to do tonight to play well?
You know, I think their hitters are going to have to handle a bigger block up in the front row. That's something Warner's hitters probably haven't faced too many 6'3 middle blockers all season, so that will be something that Warner will have to take care of in that front row, still running an effective offense with a bigger block up in front of them than perhaps they're used to.
Parker in the blue, Warner will be in the white jerseys. Nice to have you with us on SDPB.org. A reminder, third place in the championship on SDPB1 tomorrow night, 6 Central, 5 Mountain. We're ready to roll. Jenny Smith serving it off for Parker. Boy, right away, Warner going to Peyton Ellingson, the freshman.
You know, she does a great job. She jumps, she reaches so high. You know, at 6 feet tall with a long wingspan, she takes that ball pretty high right over the top of that block.
Doesn't look like a freshman at all playing out there.
Well, she played last year as an eighth grader, so she's got some experience behind her, so she's not your typical freshman.
Roselle setting up, Ellingson again with the kill. It'll be interesting to see what Parker, how they challenge at the net. They're going to go with one blocker, or they're going to go with two blockers? And which two blockers are they going to use?
Yes. Getting up and double blocking on that quick is going to be important.
Double block coming that time for Warner as Hannah Carlson trying to go on the attack. Serving is Ashley Roselle, a 5'11 senior. That is deep. Roselle had 78 aces during the regular season.
She doesn't miss very often, so I don't think we'll see too many more of those tonight.
That is one thing Parker can't do, is miss on the serve.
Yeah, unforced errors. Warner doesn't need Parker's help scoring points, so the more points Parker can score for itself and fewer for Warner, the better.
Looking for Harold. Double block by Warner, and then it was J.C. Schlosser coming in with the point.
She did a nice job of finding the open spot on the court with that little tip over the coverage.
Going cross court. Allison Sander, important for her to have a big night tonight.
Yes. You know, she's kind of their go-to kid on that outside. She's 5'9", but she just jumps out of the gym. And so if we can get some balls to her on the outside, that's going to be good for Parker.
That's deep. It's out. Parker comes in winning 14 matches in a row. Their only losses, they lost to Chester Area twice, and they lost to Wagner. Their only losses on the season.
Those are good teams.
Boy, straight down by Ellingson. You know when that ball is being crushed straight down, you know they're getting a good hand on the ball.
Yes. They reach really high, make a high contact point, and that's going to sail right down.
A little free ball here for Warner. Schlosser again.
Yeah, Parker needs to get a good pass up on serve receive so they can run their offense. They cannot give Warner free balls all night.
Describe that last play.
That's a great look by Ashley Roselle. She saw that the left back defender, Allison Sanner, had backed up a little bit there, and so she just tipped that ball right over the net.
It's having good vision, isn't it?
Yeah, peripheral vision is important for a setter. And fewer as good as Ashley Roselle.
That is in. Is Harold able to tip that one over to score? Coming in for Parker, Mackenzie Dean. Mackenzie Dean, 97% first serve. Nice block on the back set. Allison Sanner with the block.
That should fire up the Parker Pheasants.
Well, we're seeing Parker going up with the double block on those outside hits. Riley Furman, 5'6 sophomore, serving for Warner. That is out. Strong attack, but it went out.
Ashley Roselle likes to hit that line shot when the set's nice and tight, so hopefully that right back defense is going to pick up on that, but she swung just a little bit too far out.
Sanner serving. This one needs to get over. That is out. Point Parker. How about the passing of Parker so far? You like what they're doing?
You know, if they can keep that ball a little bit farther off the net, they're going to be able to run that ball to their hitters just a little bit better. Some of those balls are a little tight. That's a good tempo pass.
And that one was hit just right into the net. How about the passing for Warner so far tonight?
Warner has tremendous passers in the back row. The two Basil sisters run a pretty tight defense back there, so not much is going to get by them and Mallory Testerman.
Alexis Basil serving for the Monarchs.
There's a good pass.
That is out. Well, Roselle with a couple of attacks that have gone wide.
Yes, and that's a good call by Allison Sanner over there. It's tough on some of those. You know, she's trying to hit that cut shot on that outside, and she knew right where that line was, and that ball was out. So that was a good call on her part.
First set, semifinals, Class B volleyball, as Roselle gets a little help from the net on that one. You played at 25. If we get to a fifth set, that you play to 15. Caitlin Basil serving. That's a great hit by Harold.
Great hit right through the block. Right through the block, right over the top. That's what Parker needs tonight.
I can see where other teams that don't have maybe the size up front, teams that have the athleticism like Warner, it doesn't take long for them to take advantage of it, just like Peyton Ellingson did right there.
Yeah, their defense is going to have to dig those balls off the net. They can't be giving lunch balls to the other team tonight. They're going to take advantage of that.
Roselle serving. That is deep. Warner up 13-9 here, first set. We'll keep you updated on the scores of the other tournament games in Watertown and in Yankton.
That's a nice dig there in the back row by their setter.
Nice dig there. Blocked at the net, goes out, point four, Warner.
That's a pretty formidable block over on that side. That was a good job by Parker by getting over there. They just need to press into the fat part of the court.
Timeout called by Coach Christensen and the Parker Pheasants. We'd love to know where you're watching us tonight. Follow us on Twitter. Use the hashtag SDVolleyball14. We'd love to know where you're watching. I know we had folks viewing last night down in Atlanta. Fans of the Chester area listening and watching the broadcast. Let us know. Join the conversation on Twitter. Use the hashtag SDVolleyball14. I assume, Coach, you're on Twitter, aren't you?
Not at all.
What? The students haven't trained you yet on Twitter?
No, I am not part of the social media world. I like to live in the real world, so.
SD Volleyball 14, let us know where you're following, where you're watching tonight. We're expecting some nice action for you here at the Class B tournament in Aberdeen. Ashley Roselle back serving. That's going to be Hannah Herlin and her first kill of the night.
Parker does a good job of getting everyone involved in their offense. They have a pretty balanced attack in that front row.
Serving is Brittany Olson.
Oh.
Big hit, Allison Sanner.
That was a tight ball, and she just got right on top of that and put it down.
Sanner had 19 kills last night. That's a pretty good dig there by the libero. Tell you what, there's some swings going on.
Yeah, Parker's doing a great job of playing defense and playing some of those balls up. It'd be great if they can get an attack on their side.
Warner brings in Ashley Fishbach. Fishbach, 5'9", eighth grader. There are four eighth graders on the roster for Warner.
And we'll probably see several of them tonight.
Fight at the net. A way to dig that out of the net. We need some pretty good rallies between. Oh, that one. Sanner can't get it up over the net. Point for Warner.
Nice pass.
Boy, the speed of Warner on some of those passes setting up. It's in. All right.
That was a good look by Allison Sanner. That little tip over to the four spot is wide open.
Right along the side of the net and the sideline.
That's a tough ball for the left front to get.
Oh, quick hit over, what a save.
Great pancake by Sanner.
Just notice that Warner, when they're passing and setting up, that their pace of setting it up is much quicker than some teams are certainly used to. Ace, Peyton Ellingson with the ace. She had 27 aces during the season, 200 blocks. You get into the 200 block category, that's having a phenomenal year. Holland, nice dig by Ellingson, and Holland going back, going up and getting it.
There we go. So we see Peyton Ellingson, usually the libero, Caitlin Basil, comes in for her, but while she's back there serving, she's got to play defense, and she typically doesn't play much back row, so you see a tight dig by her, and Parker took advantage of that.
Fun first set here in the semifinals. The winner goes to the championship match tomorrow night. Warner, two-time defending champs. Rozelle able to dig that one out. That is out. Point for Parker. Pretty good volley. Rally there by everybody.
Great defense on both sides. Oh, and a nice block there. Solo block by Allison Sanner.
Nice crowd here tonight as well in Aberdeen. Typically semifinal night. Not too bad. Oh, there's a big kill. J.C. Schlosser.
She hit that ball right between the block. That middle blocker's got to get all the way out there and close that block and help that outside blocker.
Pretty good dig there by Alexis Basil. Actually, no, that was Caitlin Basil. I mean, the speed of these balls that are being hit off some of these ladies is tremendous.
Yeah, we have good hard swings on both sides. I think you see that in several of these rallies. Warner's swinging hard, and then Parker comes right back swinging just as hard. Makes for a great match.
Ace. How many did Sanner have during the year? 49 aces during the year for Sanner.
She leads the team for Parker and aces.
She had three last night. That's out.
And some rare errors for Ashley Rozelle on that outside attack. She's trying to hit that line on that side over there and just a few inches too far.
Timeout by Warner.
Parker's doing a great job of not taking those balls that are out. A lot of times teams aren't sure if they're in or out, so they go ahead and take them anyway. They're doing a great job of watching that ball all the way to the line. They follow it.
Early first set, double A's, O'Gorman and Huron. It's 16-14, O'Gorman. Semifinal night is, no matter what sport it is, whether it's football or basketball, volleyball, it's so exciting because you're one win away from getting to a state title game. Maybe you've never been there before. Maybe it's been years before you've been there, or you've been there before and want to get back. It's an exciting night. It's tied at 19.
Yep, and here we saw just a couple unforced errors by Warner, and Parker's right back in it.
Light touch by Rozelle, dug out by Dean. Who are they going to set up?
Going to the outside.
And they got it by Hannah Herlin. First lead of the set here for Parker. Oh, what a that is a great hit by Rozelle.
Right between the defenders in the middle back.
Warner has only gone to four sets once this year, and that was under Nora Groff's Northwestern team. You're the only team that took them to four sets this year.
I I think we're about to, we could just about see another set being lost here. We're getting a great match here, 21-20.
Just how dominant Warner has been. They've played 85 sets this year. They've won 80 of them. No territory they've never been before. You want to wonder how they react to that.
You know, Warner's usually pretty patient at the end of the match. They're usually very comfortable. They finish well. You know, being tied or being down by a couple of points does not rattle them. They usually finish very strong.
Caitlin Basil, the senior, will serve for the Monarchs. Tied at 21. Someone in the net. Four hits. That ball did not go over the net. Four hits. Warner up by one. 3 points away from winning the set.
Oh, great hit.
Contessa Harold with the kill and ties it up. Parker brings in Hannah Carlson, a 5'7" right hitter.
Good coverage by Warner on that block.
Warner 2 points away from winning the set, and Roselle gonna serve.
And Warner's back to their first rotation, right where they like to be, with Asher Roselle serving, so.
Here's Harold, all swung and missed it. And now the set and a timeout by Parker. Oh, Parker stays alive. Herlin will get credit for the point. It's still, though, set point. And Brittany Olson serving it up for the Pheasants. Looking for Ellingson, and Ellingson gets the kill, and Warner wins the first set, 25-23. That was a fun first set.
That was great defense on both sides, and you could tell both offenses were running hard and swinging hard, and that's exactly what you want in a semifinal match.
You can join South Dakota Public Broadcasting on Thanksgiving Day as we present some of the state's most talented young people. Tune in and experience the talent of South Dakota high school musicians in the All-State Chorus and Orchestra Concert. Starts 1 p.m. Central, noon Mountain. And then at 3 p.m. Central, 2 Mountain, SDPB presents the Elementary Honor Choir, only on SDPB television. At the AA tournament in Yankton, O'Gorman has taken the first set over Huron. 25-18, the Lady Knights defeat Huron. Stoet O'Gorman has had a monster year. They've played a ton of matches. They even went to Vegas for a weekend to play five teams out there. They've had a whale of a season.
Yeah, they've done a good job of preparing for playing in that AA division. Huron definitely has its hands full, but I'm sure Shelley Buttonhagen has some tricks up her sleeve yet to work against O'Gorman.
As soon as I get an update on Sioux Falls Christian, I'll let you know. That one going on over in Watertown. We are ready for set two here in Aberdeen, the Class B volleyball tournament. I'm Craig Maddock, along with Northwestern head coach Nora Groff. You guys played Warner this year, of course, but you didn't play Parker this year.
We did not. We got to play Warner four times this year, but not once did we
Lucky
get to play Parker.
You.
So
that has just been a great battle over the years between Warner and Northwestern and the titles. 12 of the last 15 Class B titles have been won by either Northwestern or Warner. District 2 is a monster.
That's worked to make both of our programs better. It's an advantage for both of us. It's been really good for our athletes.
Coming in for Warner, J.C. Schlosser. Serving, Ashley Rozelle. That's in. Mallory Testerman with the kill.
And that's fun to see. Mallory's a very good back row player, and you know, she's one of the smaller kids on their roster playing in that front row. It's fun to see her get some kills up there.
Ace. Seen anything different? There's another ace by Rozelle. Have you seen anything different in Parker in the way they've started out defensively at all in this second set?
Well, I think this Ashley Rozelle likes to serve to that right back corner over there, and you've got to get that ball up to their setter.
Ellingson with the hit. She's got six kills.
Yeah, we see a single block there. You notice number four is in the front row, and she pulled off to play some defense there.
And a rotation violation. And what? It looked like Hannah Carlson was playing too far back at the start of the rotation.
That looks like she might have switched a little too early. You can switch in that front row, but not until after the contact on the serve. And sometimes those front row players like to cheat across there a little quicker.
That's Allison Sanner with the kill.
She does a great job of going up and challenging that block, making those blockers play that ball.
You like how both teams are attacking so far?
Yes, the aggressiveness is just fun to watch. Makes for great volleyball.
Oh! The slap by the freshman.
She's having a great night. Peyton Ellingson's playing really well. It's really fun to see.
Seven kills and one ace for Peyton Ellingson so far. Parker needs to get back on a scoring run here. Setting up Ellingson again.
Yeah, Peyton Ellingson's very quick, and the middle blocker for Parker's got to get out there on her when she runs that three.
That is deep. Side out for Parker. And Hannah Carlson serving for the Pheasants. That's going to be an ace. Luckily, they have a lot of area here in Aberdeen because some of these servers like to go way back.
Yeah, and it's good for the defense, too. They have a lot more room to chase down balls. We have some really good athletes in this tournament, so it's fun to see them be able to run down balls from off the court.
Schlosser hits that right into the net.
It's a good dig by Ashley Rozelle right to their libero.
Parker now with 3 points in a row.
Yeah, when Warner makes an unforced error, Parker needs to take advantage of it.
Ace! Coach Jung telling at least Ashley Fishbach to move back defensively in the back row. Rozelle back set and blocked by Allison Santer, her second block.
She did a good job of lining up with Peyton Ellingson. When you've got that outside hitter pulled back on serve receive, Peyton Ellingson's the only hitter back over here.
Right down the middle for Schlosser.
Yep, that middle blocker has got to get over there on that.
You think he got the outside hitter covered, and all of a sudden they come down the middle with another one. Ellingson serving. That is touched by Parker. Point for Warner.
Yeah, Parker's got a small blocker on that side over there with their 5-4 setter, so Schlosser's going to take advantage of that and go right over the top.
Oh, tight, very tight window for her to get that ball over the net for Schlosser. Blocked by Harold. Right down the line, that is out. Just out by Santer. Timeout. Dakota Valley leading Sioux Falls Christian in the second set. Dakota Valley also leads that match 1-0. Sioux Falls Christian, one of those other programs. They've been there 8 years in a row.
Yep, they're the only team to have beaten Warner this year.
Get to the score on that one. Back serving is Ellingson for Warner.
That was good coverage by Parker's libero.
Rozelle just finding the hole. By the way, Dakota Valley beat Sioux Falls Christian in that first set, 25-14. Santer. That'll be her kill. Let's see, Santer with 8 kills in this match.
She did a good job of contacting that ball high. It was set off the net, came right to this deep right back corner.
Harold, and that it was touched. It was gonna go wide, but it got touched by Warner.
I think we see a pattern developing here. Parker's starting to hit balls to the right back, trying to keep Ashley Rozelle busy back there playing defense rather than setting.
Back set, and Schlosser gets the kill. Riley Furman to serve, 5'6" sophomore. Big time hit right down the sideline by Hannah Herlin. And let's see, Hannah tonight, that's gonna be her fourth kill.
It was a good decision by Parker Setter to set that ball to this side instead of into the block of Ashley Rozelle. It was a good call on her part.
Rozelle has it blocked, but it's gonna go out. Last touch by Parker. It's a point for Warner. Both teams will make some changes here. Alexis Basil in for Warner. And the libero is in for Parker. Lexi Olson. Rozelle.
She did a nice job of tooling that ball right off Parker's block so it would go out of bounds.
Looking for Rozelle, blocked by Harold, and lift called against Warner.
It was good hustle by number one, Lexi Basil, to get up there and cover her hitter like that. Just needed her hands just a little bit higher. That was good coverage.
Jenny Smith on the serve. Back set. Pretty good dig by Furman. Quick touch, and it works for Hannah Carlson.
Caught Warner off guard with that one.
Rozelle.
Oh, great dig by Parker.
Testerman hit right into the net. Point for the Pheasants. We're in set number two. Warner won the first set, 25-23.
Again, nice dig by Allison Sander in that left back.
And in the net. Warner was in the net, point for Parker. And served out. Point for Warner, they'll serve. Brings Caitlin Basil to serve for the Monarchs. Ace! Basil was number three on the team in service aces. The net by Harold. Some soft touches over the net, coach. Good block by Harold.
But it's who swings hard when the ball goes down.
It's in. Point, Warner.
I think we see that a lot of times in volleyball. We get little tips and little shoots back and forth, but the kill goes to the kid who finally pounds it down hard.
Harold had a block. They had Ellingson and Roselle on the double block against Harold, and a timeout by Parker. You can purchase the DVD of any of the high school volleyball championship matches. You can call the 800 number. That'll be popping up on your screen. There it is. DVDs are $19.95 plus $5 for shipping and handling. If you're a member of Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, shipping is free. DVDs include all three matches from your team's appearance at the state tournament. Call the number or log on to sdpb.org for a copy of any of the state volleyball championship matches. Decent student section showing up tonight for both Parker and Warner. Ace. You know, those volleyball players really appreciate it when they get that student support. Even if they're dressed up the way they are. Some of them, do their mom and dads know they're out tonight?
And the girls always appreciate that when the boys get into it, that's for sure.
Setting up Roselle, blocked by Harold. Roselle was calling for that pass.
That was a great play by Contessa Harold. Peyton Ellingson's very quick, so to line up with her, that was a good job on her part.
In the net. Parker was in the net, so they will give it over to Warner. They're 3 points away from winning the set. And that's going to go out, and that's going to be a kill by Sanner. You know, Sanner tonight, that's her ninth kill. We thought she needed to have a big night tonight. Ellingson with the kill. Boy, that's one of her favorite spots.
Yeah, speaking of kids having a big night tonight, Peyton Ellingson's playing very well for Warner tonight. It's her ninth kill in the evening, and she's just having fun out there.
Callie Steinbach serving. Sanner takes it home.
I think Warner meant to double block on that, and we didn't quite get there, so put a hole in the defense. She took advantage.
Ellingson hit the top of the net, came back, and when Testerman touched it, that was your four touches. Ashley Fishbach, her first kill of the night. It is now set point for Warner.
It's a great hit by the eighth grader. She had to smile on that one.
That was a great dig. And I think Lexi Olson got hurt too. She got hurt. Are they going to count the point or are they going to call time here? Let's see. Lexi Olson hurt herself on that last dig, and they may have called time before the rally was done due to the injury. Let's see what they're going to call. Yep, they're going to replay. Lexi Olson got hurt on that dig, and either was dazed or she was limping around. I could tell when she dove that She came back kind of wandering, and she's going to stay in the match. So Carrie Jung just asking for a ruling here.
Yeah, it's not something you see very often in volleyball. When the play's still going on, that an official would call a time for the player. I think you see that in basketball happening while they'll stop the play back and forth, but that's not something we see in volleyball very often.
So they're going to replay it. This is still set point. Oh, right down the line. Warner can't quite get to it.
That was a smart shot there by Allison Sander, picking up that Peyton Ellingson was playing middle back there instead of the libero.
Still set point. There it is. Warner wins set number two, 25-20, and now lead 2-0. Warner, one of those teams, they just keep attacking and attacking. It might be Ellingson, it might be Roselle, could be Testerman coming in there. I mean, they just have so many weapons.
Yes. You know, Warner does a great job of just keeping that ball coming. They have such good defense in that back row. You know, I think everybody talks about Warner's offense, but those two, Basils and Testerman, do a great job in that back row, keeping that ball alive so that they can just swing and swing and swing.
Dakota Valley and Sioux Falls Christian going at it over in Watertown. Dakota Valley won the first set over Sioux Falls Christian, 25-14. Sioux Falls Christian right now leading 22-19 in that second set. Set two goes to Sioux Falls O'Gorman. The double A is down in Yankton, 25-23.
That's a close one.
So O'Gorman, the number one seed in double A, leading 2-0. Warner, the number one seed in Class B, is up 2-0. Sioux Falls Christian trying to even up that match with Dakota Valley.
That's a great match they have going on in Class A with the number one seed and the defending champs duking it out in the semifinals.
Just a reminder, SDPB Sports covering all of the South Dakota High School Volleyball Championship matches. Right now you're watching us online. Tournament action from all three venues online at sdpb.org. Look for the third place in the championship matches on SDPB television tomorrow night. We will be on SDPB1. The AA championship will be on SDPB2, and the Class A championship on SDPB3. Well, Parker in a spot they really haven't been in too many times. They have their backs up against the wall here. They're down two sets. No holding back now.
Yeah, they're going to have to get after it this match. And just looking at Warner's demeanor as they come out, they're all smiling and laughing and having a good time. They seem pretty relaxed and comfortable now starting set three.
Just the movement out there is just Warner. Anytime they're on, they get possession of the ball. There's so much movement going on.
Yeah, they transition very quickly. Parker's blockers are going to have to speed up their footwork and get over there.
Oh, tough play at the net there to try to set that. Sometimes when you're setting it, you don't want it too close to the net.
Yeah, when the setter's coming from the back row, it's nice if those passers can dig it to the well, as we say, get that ball up off the net. There's a great defensive pass.
Block, and it stays in. Point for Warner. To give the ball block to Schlosser. And service error. It'll go back to Parker.
Yeah, J.C. Schlosser usually hits on the outside, but in that rotation, they keep her on that right side to help block against the outside hitter. That's a good move by Carrie Jung.
Oh, Ellingson has been on fire, her 11th kill. She is just a freshman. There's a lot of great volleyball coming her way. District 2 is not happy about that. All right, tell the rest of us, why is it Warner and Northwestern volleyball has been so good, so dominant over these last decade? As that goes out, it's going to go back to Warner.
Well, in order to get to the state tournament, you know, we have to either beat Warner or Warner has to beat us. And both programs, you know, the athletes work very hard. Everybody wants to play for a state title, but no matter how hard we work, one of us has to stay home. And so that just makes everybody just be play at their very best, and they have to work their hardest if they want to get here. So in order to get here, you kind of have to be good enough to beat the top team. So once you get to the state tournament, you kind of feel like sometimes the toughest work is over.
Sander on that last block, but it went out. The point by Warner. Sander will try it again. Another double block by the Monarchs. There's a double block by Parker. Oh, in the corner where nobody was, and Warner gets the point.
It's a smart play by Kelly Steinbach in Warner's middle.
Well, this season isn't it just from August to November either for these young ladies. These ladies, of all the ladies we'll see in the state tournament, that's going to go out. How much time are they putting in the summer with volleyball?
Well, the volleyball season isn't just 3 months in the fall. You know, kids are, you know, a lot of these kids are multi-sport athletes.
Time out here for Parker.
And, you know, they run strength and conditioning programs in the summer. They're going to camps. They're playing in leagues. These kids put a lot of time in the gym with open gyms and just, you know, they get a lot of touches on the ball, and it's made them better volleyball athletes. You know, the more touches they can get, the better they're going to be. You know, a lot of these kids from Parker and Arlington and Warner, they play club volleyball in the spring, so, you know, they get extra touches that way too. So, you know, these kids put a lot into it. They just don't roll the balls out in August. You don't play at this level by just touching a ball for 3 months.
What's the level of volleyball like now in South Dakota over the last 10 years?
You know, it's gotten a lot better. It's gotten a lot better. Volleyball is the most popular sport for girls in South Dakota. We have almost 1,000 more girls playing volleyball than we do basketball in this sport. And I know a lot of times we think we're a basketball state, but for girls, volleyball is the most popular, and it's the most popular for girls across the country. We have more girls playing volleyball than just about anything else. So, you know, it's got something for every size athlete, and, you know, it's a real team sport, and I think that really plays to girls' mentality.
Roselle serving. And somebody was in the net. I think it was Sander.
Yeah, she didn't mean to. That was just a tight ball there.
So the point will go to Warner. Sander trying to get a, oh, that was a great dig by Ellingson.
She's long. She's got a long platform, a big reach.
Give the point to Hannah Carlson.
Well, she tends to get a point on that side every time, right before she rotates out. I think that's the third time in a row.
Setting it up for Christensen. Back to Christensen, and it's out. wasn't that long ago where we didn't have the rally scoring, where you had to score once you served it.
Yeah.
You could only get a point when you served. And those matches would take forever.
Well,
some nights.
They'd either take 20 minutes or 2.5 hours. You just never knew. Now with the rally scoring, we know how long a match is going to last.
That is how it's another point for Warner. Well, it helps the fans, too. I mean, that I think it's helped the fans more than it has with the players.
Yeah, it's definitely made it more fan-friendly. They know when it's a point for the other team. But it certainly has changed the way we play the game and how we teach it. You know, unforced errors are an automatic point for the other team.
And that was a service error and that or a hitting error, and it's back to Parker. We're in set three. Oh, right at the net, Jenny Smith. That might be her easiest kill all night long.
Yeah, and that's an unusual passing error for Ashley Roselle. Usually she's spot on with those. That's a good dig by Parker's libero.
Boy, a lot of Parker pheasants right there in that corner. Your teams like to inch up closer to the net all the time.
Yeah, Parker gets sucked up into that corner up there, and then, you know, it'd be nice if they could change the flow and hit something on this backside as Warner gets sucked over there as well.
Soft touch. Oh, too soft. Didn't even go over the net by Christensen.
Yep, she thought she saw an opening there in that little left back right over the net, and just didn't quite get it over.
Need to get this over. Point for Warner. And Joe Christensen, the head coach at Parker, the all-time winningest volleyball coach, South Dakota volleyball, over 700 career victories, 32 years. Carrie Jung, by the way, she's top eight, I think ranked eighth all-time wins with 447. And Coach Groff, you're not that far behind either. you're pretty close.
Yeah, I've been head coach for 13 years, so Jill's got quite a jump start on me. I don't know that I'll be coaching when I'm 54 years old on my birthday. I mean, what a great person she is, and what a great asset for those Parker pheasants. Those girls are so lucky to have her. Such a knowledgeable and experienced coach.
Serving for Warner is Caitlin Basil. Oh, a fight at the net. Oh, that long arms of Peyton Ellingson, able to tip it in the air right at the net. And toss it where nobody else is located.
Yeah, Jenny Smith did a nice job of trying to get up there, but at 5-4, she's just not going to have the same reach.
Oh, fight at the net. Oh, somebody was in the net. Officials going to talk this one over. This one might be a replay.
This could have been both sides.
That's what it looked like. Could have been both sides. They may replay this one. No, they're going to give it to Parker. He had a few bodies there fighting at the net. So they rule it Parker gets the point.
Carrie Jung not happy with that call. She wanted to know which player was in the net, and didn't get a response from our official Brian Kringen here on that one. So as a coach, you like to know which player was in the net.
That is right down the line by Roselle. I know I wouldn't want to be on the end of those attacks. Just the athleticism and the strength these young ladies are bringing forth. That one was hit right into the net. Hannah Carlson couldn't get that one over the net. And the timeout's going to be called by the Parker Pheasants.
Ooh-ha, ooh-ha.
Sioux Falls Christian did win that second set at the Class A, 25-21. So Sioux Falls Christian and Dakota Valley, they're in their third set, tied one apiece. Roselle back serving for the Monarchs. And they'll give that one to Schlosser, the point.
Parker needs to start passing that ball up to their setter. Warner's starting to run away with this. There's a good pass.
Dig by Roselle. Schlosser fighting there in the net with Harold. And Schlosser wins the battle. Warner is 5 points away from going back to the state championship. And that's going to be out. Point for Parker. Pheasants will bring in Brittany Olson to serve. Looking for Sanner. Cross court smash by Allison Sanner. Ellingson with her 13th kill.
Yeah, the freshman's having a great night tonight.
Checking what Ellingson had last night for kills. She had 12 last night. That was down the line, but it was outside the line. Point for Warner. They're 3 points away of winning the match. Parker showing no signs of giving up. Still playing hard. Sanner. And that one goes deep.
That was a good hard hit by Sanner. She tried to hit that sharp cross set again. Testerman played that ball up.
Service error. Heading over to Parker. Lexi Olson, the 5'7 sophomore, serving. Boy, the swing and the hit and the kill. Oh, she had plenty of time to get on the swing on that one. Ellingson with 14 kills. Match point here for the Warner Monarchs. And the kill by Schlosser, and Warner is going back to the championship game as they take care of Parker in the third set, 25-10. Warner wins it, 25-23, 25-20, 25-10. Warner improves to 33-1. Parker will fall to 29-4. Coach, observations. First, Warner Monarchs. Played like they normally do tonight, right?
They look like they typically do, yeah. Warner's just very consistent. I think their advantage tonight was that they were quicker in transition. You know, they got off that net and ran right back on with quick hits. And, you know, Parker wasn't able to get their block over there in time. And so many times, like Ellingson on that last hit, there's no block over there. So that's fun for them when you're 5'11 or 6 feet tall and you have no block up there. You can just swing hard and put that ball down. So they transitioned quickly, and I think that was kind of the key for them tonight.
How about Parker?
You know, I thought Parker fought hard. They, you know, they put up a good block at times, and, you know, and they hit hard. They were hitting hard, but, you know, Warner's got good defense behind their hitters as well. So, you know, a tough loss for Parker, but they should definitely be proud of the season that they've had.
They will play for third place tomorrow night. Parker will play the third place match tomorrow night. We'll be on the air on SDPB1 at 6 o'clock tomorrow night with that and also the championship match. As Warner going back to the championship, they are the two-time defending champs. Who will they play? Well, we'll find out in about 25 minutes. That's when Sully Buttes and Chester area will go at it. We will step away for a moment, and we'll be back in about 20 minutes to get you the start of Chester area and Sully Buttes. We'll also keep you posted on the other matches going on. Let me just give a quick check here, Coach, and see if we have an update. Well, Gorman was up 2-0 over Huron. And Sioux Falls Christian, Dakota Valley, having a pretty good battle over in Watertown, as they are tied at 1-1. And nothing to share right now, but you can follow those as well at sdpb.org. For Nora Groff, head coach at Northwestern, I'm Craig Maddock. We're back in about 20 minutes. We'll have the other semifinal match of the Class B volleyball tournament here in Aberdeen.